And again, departing suburbia. And finally out of it. Anyway, here's today's agenda. Approaching the fork area. And up here to the right was a former gas station. See if the camera picks it out. Yeah, part of it there. And I'm old enough to recall when the place still ran. And again, I've had to pick up US 1 northbound. We usually do that at this point. We somehow always wind up on this road, don't we? Because to get a free crossing of the Susquehanna over Conowingo Dam. Good reason. Other bridges cost toll money. Free crossing this way. I guess I'm cheap. This way, the state doesn't make any money off of me. They're making enough collecting taxes. Anyway, not a bad day out there though, on this November day. Temps in the 60s, and not a cloud in the sky. I guess today we have severe clear. Oh, cliffs again, that's right. Liquors and auto parts. As I said over and over, I guess cliff is very diverse. But suddenly come to a full stop, just before Conowingo Dam. Wonder what gives, or takes, whatever. We moved a couple of feet since the last scene. Oddly enough, nobody coming the other way. An occasional vehicle passes, but that's about it. Nobody there now coming even the other way. So, isn't it that Conowingo Dam? We've begun to move, however slowly it is. We'll see what happens up ahead when we get to the dam. Just past a sign for road work. So I guess there's road work going on by the dam. Well, we'll soon find out. But again, no one's passed the other direction in a while. So I guess both directions are closed down. And now we do have traffic coming the other direction, going southbound. Well, we did. What if that means we'll be moving soon? Come on, I've got to get this thing on the move. There's a sign for it. But we have to get there first. And again moving. Let's see how far we get. Well, stay in your lane, idiot. One lane road. There's our problem. Bridge work. Or more like dam work. That dam work is slowing us down. Finally made it here. Well, the progress is still slow. Are we going to get stopped again down there? No, we're keeping on moving. That's good. Made it over the dam finally. Head south. Oh, good. This road looks good. And once again, port deposit. How fast am I going? Hope I'm speeding. this town is incorporated and has a mayor, but he gets paid just $25 a week. Wow, he must be rich. I'll take that job. And at the stop sign once again, the original route from Baltimore to Philadelphia, Philippines at the left, to the north. I'm not taking you over it. Up here in this town, they take their turtles seriously. I had to ascend up and out. Wow, a steep hill to pedal up, hold on. But as long as I'm in the area, I guess I'll check out the CSX holly trees and see when this year's tree lighting ceremony will be. Normally it's the second Saturday, I mean the first Saturday in December. But we'll have a look. And up here, CSXE itself. And we've arrived. And the tree's all decked out. And there it is, December 7th. And I'll be here to cover it, as I usually do. I can't forget Santa night. And again, our holly trees, complete with ornaments. Gotta be politically correct these days, or they'll get you. But the one over here appears to have been trimmed back a bit. It's a bit shorter than last year, compared to the one over here. Yep, I'll be here to cover the ceremony. Your frog will be here. In fact, that one there, the shorter one, has purple lights for the Baltimore Ravens, who are doing rather well as of this video. And of course, we're again by CSX, their Philadelphia subdivision, or affectionately known as the Philly Sub. Looking east, it'd be great to get a train coming from that direction, going westbound, because eastbound, coming this direction, the lighting is horrendous. But I unfortunately can't wait for a train, because of all the time wasted at the Cunawingo construction site, which I didn't see much of. There is something I want to check out over the PA line. See if I get to it in time. Now picking my way through the back roads. I wish there's more to show you on this road. But not a whole heck of a lot. Oh well. And beneath this bridge up here, once ran the Oxbarrow Secondary. This part got abandoned in the late 1950s. And down there, Oxbarrow Creek. I guess it got the name from the railroad. Or is it vice versa? And the pier, we're about to cross over Route 1. And now the road becomes US 222 northbound. Southbound from Route 1, it's a state highway. North of Route 1, it's a US highway. One of our former stops here, the USA Liquors, formerly Johnston's Liquors. One of our one-time former stops. I should have made it a present stop. But up ahead, we'll be crossing the Mason-Dixon. And here it is about to happen. Yeah, it's in Pennsylvania. You're right. Now to look for a certain road. Cool valley here. Looks even more cool in the snow. I found the road I was looking for. This is Furnace Road. With some scenery. Stuff there. Yep, once again, stuff that time forgot. And back into the woods for a while. Only one problem living in the woods, it gets dark early. You don't have much daylight in these valleys. Out of the valley, you face the sun. Video is almost impossible, as is driving. I can't see where I'm going. I'm facing away from the sun now, a bit easier to drive. Now we're on Susquehannock Drive, heading for the park by that name. I hope. Now on the drive leading to the park, although I can't see where I'm going. Alright, I can see again. The sun's behind the trees. Well, we're in the park. Someplace there's a pathway. It takes you to an overlook, overlooking the Susquehanna. You finally made it to our overlook. And here it is in this direction. In the sun. Yes, we're here. And down there, our river. The old Susquehanna. And then looking southeast. Down the Susquehanna. First time seeing this view for me. But my brother's been here before, and he has his own YouTube video posted of this place. But check out mine. And this is northwest up the river. In the distance, the PA 372 bridge, which we'll soon be crossing. Out of sight to the trees there is the Muddy Run power plant, which I've taken it to before. Got these cool telescopes here. That's gonna put a coin in to operate. So for that reason, your bullfrog doesn't mess with them. And she's shooting her video, competing with me.
I heard you.
Which she can't do.
Yeah, I'm screeched. Anyway, here's this little map again.
And to the southeast, the Peach Bottom Nuclear Power Plant, which I've also shown you before. First time seeing it from this vantage point. trying to get the FYI here. But this sign is at a bad angle. Yes, that's where we are. And all the cool Susquehanna Islands. And the bridge will soon be crossing. Yeah, maybe it is. Okay, best get back to the vehicle now. Getting cold and windy out here. And almost sunsets of the park will soon close. But before departing, little item of interest here. A unisexy bathroom. Well, I'm only one sex, so I guess I get to go in there. And it's even heated. It was kind of warm in there. All right, we're gone. And back on the road to take us out of the park. My brother was back there a few Saturdays ago. But today was my first time. And we're out of here. At least now I can see where I'm going. I'm not being blinded. I'm blinded by the light. But I'm not going to repeat the next line of that song. For those who recall what the next line is. Oh, nice farm. Interesting lighting with the sun down like that. Cool pass to the west. Now we're west on something called River Road. But soon we'll curve to the north. And this road, if followed far enough, will take it to the Three Mile Island Nuclear Power Plant. But a couple months back, it got decommissioned. I guess that's what occurred back in 79. What could they do? Nice sunset colors, though. But again up here, my lady's ancestors, still doing their horse and buggy thing. Yep. Swiss folks. Yep. My lady's ancestors. Mine are all dead, as I keep saying. Took a different road. And again, descending into the Susquehanna Valley. There isn't a route around that way, now closed off. But I recall when it was open, and I've driven it a couple times. Passing beneath the Colombian port deposit line. Oh, nice tunnel. The old road at one time would have come down from that grade, and then joined this. But I recall when it still was there. And up ahead, the Mundy Run power plant I mentioned a little while ago. I have a night shot on Google Maps. Just pulled a 3-point turn. I'll draw it up there, a bit more visible now. Got a cool turbine sitting over there. Is it a spare or just for show? Anyway, we're out of here. Get back under the railroad. Yeah, I'll stop. When I feel like it. Y'all blow the horn for all y'all.
Beep.
Good reverb there. And over there is the reservoir that feeds the turbines. During the day, the plant generates electricity with the water, but at nighttime, they reverse the turbines. They become pumps to refill the lake. That's how this here system works. And you're still a nice sunset. And the same horse and buggy we saw a few minutes ago, we caught up to it. And they're pulling over, how nice. Hey guys. Keep it up. All right, hang a left. Now on PA 372. They're about to cross a bridge, I showed you in the distance a little while ago. Up here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Crossing the entire side of the Susquehanna. A few years back, I was slowing down for some Amish around here, and somebody sped by me, somebody passed me rather dangerously. I can't be flying through here. Now approaching PA 74. Which will take southbound. You can barely see the sign there. But trust me, this is it. All right, hang a left, just as they are. And again, one more of these. With oncoming traffic. I'm surprised they take the chance and come out this time of night after dark. Where are they going? The Walmart? And up here, one more of these inane traffic circles because people can't slow down. So because a few people can't slow down, then we all gotta slow down. I guess one jerk on the road, I suppose it's for everybody. What's the gas price up here? They're way more than Maryland. Yep. Best to buy your gas in Maryland, then come here. And folks, to me, it's cheaper to live up here. You want to bet? And up ahead here, we cross back into Maryland. Yep, there is the sign. And the state line. Okay, we are no longer out of state or out of mind. Well, maybe out of mind. Now we're in the Whiteford area. Although we're not passing through Whiteford proper. Whiteford improper. One more inane circle. Hold on while your frog negotiates it. The gas is better priced here, at least. So buy your gas in Maryland, then go to Pennsylvania. Are those two planets up there? I think Jupiter and Venus are supposed to be in view for next week and a half. Could that be those? Maybe the brighter one's Jupiter? Or is the brighter one Venus because it's closer to the sun? I wonder. Anyway, here's Jarrettsville. We've departed it. And now stopping for a light in Upper Crossroads. A place we used to ride our bikes to back in the day. Make your left turn. And we're finally out of here. Another 25 minutes back to the big city. But even shorter on the video. Here's our next locality. A place called Baldwin. And up here we turn right to continue south. Back towards Fat City. It ain't that skinny. As I keep saying, get your gas here. Then go to PA. I guess it's rush hour now, being it's Monday. Hence the northbound traffic out of the city. Going the other way. Now arriving, Glenarm. And up on the left again somewhere, the Monpah Railroad Station. But no longer used as such. Part of it there. In fact, no longer used as anything anymore. It became a carryout shop, then a restaurant, then a pizza shop, and now nothing. Let's pick a hobby shop back there. Anybody want to go in with me? And to the right, the Iron Horse Inn. Happily named because the Monpah once ran on that ridge up there. Of course, can't see it now. Now arriving back in civilization. There, I got the word out. You're back in suburbia, at last. And back in Urbia, otherwise known as Baltimore. And once again, your bullfrog is back in the hood. For lack of a better word to call it. Once again, thank you very much for the privilege of your time. Hope you enjoyed today's destinations. We went to a brand new one today, where you and I haven't been. And, as the song says, if you're ever in the area, come on up to the house. Of course, this is one house that Robin Leach will be visiting very soon, because I'm not rich and famous, but still, come on up.